Hey guys, it's Layla Kalan. I'll be doing the triangles of the neck today. And anemonic is there are two of them because we can divide the triangle the neck into the anterior and the posterior triangle. So for the anterior triangle, you've got the mnemonic, chocolate, strawberries, sand, marvelous. And for the posterior triangles, I'm gonna write anterior over here. And for the posterior triangles, you've got just two letters because it's divided into two triangles. So you just have OS, you can remember it as OS or operating system, which is kind of lame, but this is what it actually stands for. So there we are. So first, we start with C. S, and M. Now, so C, chocolate, stands for the carotid or triangle or the caroticum triangle, which is head. Okay, then for S, we've got the submental triangle. For the other S, you've got the submandibular triangle, and then for the last one, you've got the muscular triangle. Yes. So, first we'll talk about like the borders, and then we'll talk about the contents. Okay. So for the carotid triangle, it's where the common carotid artery bifurcates into the internal and the external carotid arteries. So we've got this is our triangle. For the base, we've got the superior belly of the omohyoid muscle, and to form the apex, we've got the sternocleidomastoid and the posterior belly of the digastric. Right, so posterior digastric, and we've got the sternocleidomastoid. Then if you move on to the contents, I told you about the carotid arteries, the common, the external, and the internal. You've got the cervical branch of cranial nerve number 7. You've got the vagus nerve, the accessory nerve, and you have the glossal nerves. You've got several arteries like the superior thyroid, the ascending pharyngeal, the lingual, the facial arteries, etc. You've got the transverse cervical nerve, you've got the internal jugular vein, etc. Okay, that's for the carotid triangle. Then we move on to the submental triangle. Now the submental is the chin, the mental, right? So you've got the apex, which is the chin, which goes down to the hyoid bone. So that's the apex of the chin. Then you go to the hyoid bone, and then you've got another line, this one. It forms the anterior belly of the digastric. Okay? Alright, then here we've only got like the tributaries that lead to the internal jugular vein, but you can write submental lymph nodes with you. Mental lymph nodes. Then we move on to the submandibular triangle. From the name, you know that it's below the mandible. So for here, the contents, obviously, you've got the submandibular gland, you've got the submandibular lymph nodes, and you've got the hypoglossal nerve, the mylohyoid nerve, the facial artery and vein. Okay, so here we've got the mandible as the base, mandible. Then the digastric muscle forms the apex. So you've got the anterior and the posterior bellies of the digastric. Alright,
Then the last one we've got, the muscular triangle, which consists of the infrahyoid muscles, which is why it's called muscular. So it's got the infrahyoid muscles, and also several organs like the pharynx, the thyroid, the parathyroid. Then we've got the, so here we've got the, it's not exactly a triangle, but I'll let you know. So this is the hyoid bone, okay? And then we're from here, and this one's the superior belly of the ovoid. Okay? And then we've got here, which is the sternocleidomastoid, and this would be the midline of the neck. So you can see the midline of the neck and the hyoid bone, the kind of form a triangle, so that's what is the muscular triangle, and that is it for the anterior. For the posterior, we've got OS, we go back to our red pen. Here we've got the first is the occipital triangle, and then we've got the supraclavicular, and it's also called omoclavicular or subclavian triangle. Okay, so now the occipital triangle consists of the accessory nerve, the supraclavicular nerve, the transverse cervical nerves, the brachial plexus also crosses the space. You've got the external jugular vein. These are the main ones. Yeah, that's it. So then we've got the trapezius here. We've got the omohyoid here, and we've got the sternocleidomastoid. These muscles are supplied by the accessory nerve. So if you knew that, you kind of guess what consists, what is in the space, and also what muscles are there as the boundaries. And then you've got the omohyoid. Pretty simple. Then we move on to the supraclavicular triangle. This one is, as the name suggests, it's above the clavicle. So you've got the clavicle as our base. Then we've got the sternocleidomastoid. Then we've got the inferior belly of the omohyoid. Okay. Now here you've got the nerve to the subclavius. I also told you it's got subclavian triangle, so you've got the nerve to the subclavius. You've got the subclavian artery. And you could also say you've got the external jugular vein. That is it for the triangles of the neck. These are the important ones. If you like this video, please do give it a thumbs up and do subscribe for more videos. If you need any other topics, please do comment below and I'll be sure to make one. Thank you guys. Take care. See you.